Yeah, I was going to say,
but it is that was second.
Call to order, Town of Prescott Valley, regular town council meeting, November 7th, 2019. I'd like to welcome down Chaplain John Irati, Prescott Valley Police Department. Please stand for the invocation, please.
Good evening. Lord, as we gather here today at this council meeting, we ask that you help us make wise decisions for the town of Prescott Valley and for its future. We pray for every person seated here in this chamber. You have done wonderful works and things for this council, and we pray that the Lord, you continue to give wisdom to those discussing and making decisions on the upcoming issues. As a retired police officer and a police chaplain for the Prescott Valley Police Department, I know the dangers of officers who face each day as they go out to protect their communities. We pray for all these officers and for those that are being honored and promoted tonight. We also pray for the newest police officer in this town, which is Chief Steve Rosser, and pray that you, Lord, give him the strength and wisdom to lead the men and women of his department in a manner pleasing to you. In the name of the Father and our Lord Jesus Christ, amen.
Amen.
Thanks, sir. Please remain standing while we join me in the pledge. I pledge allegiance
to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Welcome, everyone. Before we get started, just so we all know and we're all on the same page, we're going to start off with the swearing-in of our new police chief. And then we're going to skip down on our agenda to the Citizens Academy graduation. We will then welcome them and congratulate them. And then we will all take about a 10-15 minute break after that. So if you would, please just stick around for after the graduation and then have some cookies, I think it is, cookies and muffins, maybe probably even donuts. I don't know what we got going on. So.
Sweet.
But with that being said, I'm going to invite council down front.
We got to do roll call first.
Oh, I'm sorry. We do have to do roll. Clerk? I got excited there.
What is the donuts?
Yeah.
Vice Mayor Nye.
I am here.
Council member Anderson.
Here.
Councilmember Grossman.
I'm here.
Councilmember Hunt.
Here.
Councilmember Packard.
Present.
Councilmember Schumacher.
Here.
And we all know Mayor Thalgood is here.
Thank you. Appreciate that, ma'am. Thank
we
you, President.
We have a quorum.
Stand by, everyone. At this time, Judge Carson. Chief? So, Chief, invite your wife up, please.
Please raise your right hand and repeat after me. I, Stephen W. Roser, do solemnly swear.
I, Stephen W. Roser, do solemnly swear.
That I will support the Constitution of the United States.
That I will support the Constitution of the United States.
And the Constitution and laws of the State of Arizona.
In the Constitution and laws of the State of Arizona.
That I will bear true faith and allegiance to the same.
That I will bear true faith and allegiance to the same.
And defend them against all enemies, foreign and domestic.
And defend them against all enemies, foreign and domestic.
And that I will faithfully and impartially.
And that I will faithfully and impartially.
Discharge the duties of the office of police chief.
Discharge the duties of the office of police chief.
According to the best of my ability.
According to the best of my ability.
So help me God.
So help me God.
Congratulations.
A man of few words, but I do want to say that I am very honored to have been selected as your police chief. As stated earlier, I will do my best to do a great job for the town of Prescott Valley. I'm very honored to be your police chief, and thank you for having me here. I hope to do the best I can. Thank you.
Just real quickly, the chief just mentioned he was happy to be selected. On behalf of the town of Prescott Valley, I just want to just say thank you for him picking us for being the town of Prescott Valley. He could have went to many different places and been a chief at many different towns and cities, and we are fortunate to have this man. So, sir, thank you for choosing Prescott Valley.
Yes.
Just real quickly, we want to recognize our 27th graduating class of the Citizens Academy tonight. And we have 29 graduates in the current class, and over the past nearly a decade and a half, we've had 718 residents go through this program. We've already got 30 on the wait list for the next class. We had two more come in today. So we are looking forward to continuing that program. There's a couple of applications on the table if anybody here tonight is interested in signing up. And with that, we're going to try and make this short and sweet. We have a lot of people here tonight. So as I call your name, please come down. Several of these people will not be here tonight, but we'll do as many as we can. Is this working? All right, Mary Axelrod. No, Mary tonight. Michelle, I'm going to say this wrong. Michelle. She's...
I won't be so open.
Chicarillo, how could you not say that?
Congratulations. Here, you say it.
Congratulations.
Chicarillo.
Okay, from the... You heard it. Mary Dunaway. That one's a little easier. Mary joins us from Paradise, California. Interesting thing about Mary. So she's had quite the journey to get here. Dave Erlach. Dave? Not here. Gabriel Gutierrez. It's Gabriel right here. Don Harris?
Congratulations.
Right here in front. Hannah Hovelsrud.
Thank you.
There she is, over here.
Congratulations.
And we have one of our council members that's graduating tonight. And her husband is Dean here, Lori and Dean Hutt. There's Dean. We got to recognize Dean.
Good stuff. Congratulations.
Sandra Laney. And Sandy Lightfoot. You can clap. Sandy Lightfoot. James McIntyre. And Ramona Ogburn, right here.
Thank you so very much. You're fabulous. Thank you, sir.
Melanie Sue Pierce. Lashika Samuels Davis. Lashika. She's our payroll person, so maybe she's payroll. Janice and Shannon Schenagel, mother and daughter. Shannon's a library employee. I don't see Shannon or her mother here. Okay. Here. Clap for him. It's okay. Steve and Tricia Schwartz. Right here. Barbara Smith. Barbara Smith. Not here. And Deanna and Caitlin Tarrant, another mother-daughter combo. I don't see them here tonight. Hugo Yulin. Hugo. All right. Steve Allender. No, Steve. Bill Vogel. Here we go.
Congratulations.
And David and Sharon Vogt. Lashika just got up here. We'll do her last. David Winandy. David? No. Lashika, come on up.
What was her last name?
Lashika Samuel Davis. Did you get payroll done? Yeah? No.
Thank you.
Wait, I'm digging.
He's digging. No problem.
You up. I'll find it. We'll get it to you.
Is it Lashika?
Lashika.
You have to.
Trisha Schwartz. It's not my wife. My wife would appreciate it.
There it is. Got it.
Yes, Lashika.
Thank you.
All right, everyone. Hey, one more round of applause for these folks. They took time out of their day during the week to just learn a little bit more about the town, and we cannot say enough about that, and thank you. And with that being said, we're going to break for 10 or 15 minutes. Enjoy, say hello, get pictures. That's about it. Let's go. Everyone, can you just find your seats, please? We're just going to jump right into 6A, Visionary Awards Recognition of Recipients. Mr. Tarkowski, do you know who's presenting on that?
I don't know nothing about it. What?
That's your thing.
Visionary Awards Recognition of... That is Mr.
This is... may want to ask him to come up.
Yeah, I'm
Ben, come on down. Were you just going to wait for him to try to figure that out? Or yes. Perfect. Welcome.
Thank you. And I know it mentions as well that Lindsay Quisenberry also was awarded the...
Can't hear you,
the,
Ben.
The same.
Speak into the microphone.
Lindsay Quisenberry was also awarded the same Prescott Area Youth, or Prescott Area, youth, what are we? Prescott Area Young Professionals. I'm not that young, right? We were both awarded the Visionary Award, which we were very honored for. Lindsay serves on our Arts and Culture Commission, and of course, you know my role.
Yeah, and this is important for everyone to know that these two folks were the only ones representing us for Prescott Valley, and to be able to receive this award is just huge, and it says a lot about the future of Prescott Valley and what we have here with the town. So for that, I thank you both. You both are more than deserving for this, and I don't know if you can win it back-to-back, but if so, I think you should give it a shot.
Thank you, Mayor.
No, I believe you might want to have to say a few words.
You can talk about Ben.
You can talk about Ben. I'm not sure about Ben's stuff. But I practice volunteerism just within my life and within my family, and got real hooked on that movie Yes Man and kind of took the opportunity to do almost everything, especially after I moved here, and that's how I got on the Arts and Culture Commission. I do food drives every year. I emceed a circus in Paulden once, and I find that
no comment from anyone. Okay, let's just leave it at as is.
And I find that all of these opportunities continuously come up, and they make me appear to be like a really cool person. But like, I'm just showing up. That's almost all of it is just being there and being present and being willing to help in whatever way you can. I talk a lot, and so bringing me in to talk is absolutely fine. But like petting cats, not my thing. But if it's your thing, I strongly encourage everybody to find their own little selfish piece and volunteer through it. If that's playing cards, if that's petting cats, if that's making art and donating it, joining a commission, wherever your strong suit is and what you want to do, I encourage you to do that. And practice that volunteerism.
Again, thanks, guys, for doing what you do.
Thank you, Mayor.
Moving on, Trace Gordon. Trace is Gordon, new CSO supervisor.
Come on down, Traces. Mayor and Council, as always, thank you for the opportunity to acknowledge our incredible personnel like Traces. Especially as they get promoted. So Trace has served as a community services officer for quite a while before recently being promoted to support services division supervisor. So a little bit about Trace. She is a Miami Beach native. She moved to West to Denver, Colorado, where she pursued her dream to become a police officer. She attended two police academies, settling at Inglewood Police Department, where she worked for over 17 years. Traces obtained her bachelor's degree in criminal justice and graduated with honors. She held numerous assignments while at Inglewood Police Department, some of which include being a crime scene investigator, crisis negotiator, field training officer, internal affairs investigator. How long were you there? 17 and a half years. Wow. Field training officer, internal affairs investigator, criminal... Do you just want to take my job now?
No.
Okay. Criminal detective and traffic DUI officer. Highly qualified. Her favorite assignment being a DARE officer where she taught in local schools for several years. Upon retirement, Traces relocated to Houston and later to Dewey to be near family. She worked part-time at the Prescott Police Department for 5 years, where we stole you from.
Yes.
as a crime prevention specialist, where she helped earn 4 national awards for crime prevention. Tracis joined the Prescott Valley Police Department in January of 2016 as a support services community service officer. She later transferred to our Victims of Crime Act section and assisted with domestic violence victims as well as victims across all crime. You know, one thing I want to just break from and acknowledge is the incredible work that she and our Victims of Crime unit does. We are one of just a few jurisdictions in the state that can say that if you are a victim of crime in Prescott Valley, you're going to have personal contact, not just with the individual who takes the report at first, but somebody like Tracis who's going to help you to recover from that crime and avoid being victimized again. Tracis was recently promoted to support services supervisor, which is why we are here to acknowledge her tonight.
Thank you very, very much for entrusting me to lead this section, and it's very, I'm very honored to represent our town and serve our community. So thank you very much.
Awesome. Thank you, ma'am. Next up, if we could get Tim Yogerst to come on down here.
So we are acknowledging Tim's promotion from Animal Control Officer to Animal Control Supervisor. Tim was born in Arizona and raised in Dewey. Tim worked, I promise we'll get a chance to clap in just a minute. Tim worked at Young's Farm in his youth and helped various other farms and ranches across Arizona handling their livestock. Tim attended Bradshaw Mountain High School. He's got 20 years experience as executive manager for a Chevron, and wanting a change of pace, started working with an exploration drilling outfit, Core Drilling for Uranium. Wow. Sweet. Tim later ran a local barbecue restaurant in Prescott Valley, Great Food, with his family. Tim is married with 2 daughters and has worked for the Prescott Valley Police Department since 2017. Tim is currently working as our animal control supervisor. Just one other thing I want to say about Tim, he's probably one of the most humble people that we have working for us. A lot of the things that are acknowledged in this bio, I had to pull out of him during a recent conversation in his office, and we're grateful to have you. So we're fortunate to have the Yogersts serving us with the town of Prescott Valley. This is Marie, Tim's wife.
All right. Well done, sir. Tim, man a few words. All right, at this time, are the pictures for Tim? Okay.
Got it?
She did already.
All right, it's time to welcome John Darling down to the front.
John Darling's 15-year service award. John Darling and his wife made the decision to relocate to our beautiful town in 2002. They began a new journey here and have made our town their home. Married for 32 years, they enjoy camping and gardening and riding in their dune buggy on the weekends. John has a sister living in Arizona, and the 2 brothers are out of state. John started working for the town's facilities department in 2004. With training, learning, and growing his skills in the facilities department, he has worked his way up to building maintenance technician. He covers a wide range of tasks, maintaining the 11 town-owned buildings and responding to hundreds of work orders each month. His commitment and dedication to his work has made our work environment safe and comfortable. John's skills in maintaining our buildings and performing the work in-house has saved the town thousands of dollars in repairs. His support of the facilities team is unwavering. We are very thankful for John and glad he has chosen the town to devote his career and skills to. We are lucky to have him as part of our facilities team in Public Works. Please join us in congratulating John Darling for his 15 years of dedicated service. We look forward to him being with us for another 15 years.
I just got to thank everybody that came here, and hopefully I can get many more years in. Thank you.
Bravo.
Throw it out there, but do we have someone for Chamber of Commerce?
They have asked that they be excused for the evening. They're not able to make it.
Sounds good. We'll kind of jump past that one, but again, as last week, we're going to just move number 8, move right into number 9. Consent agenda. All matters listed under consent agenda are considered routine by the town council and will be enacted by one motion. There will be no separate discussion of these items. If discussion is desired, that item will be removed from the consent agenda and will be considered separately for discussion and possible action. Council, we've all had a chance to review. Are there any specifics we want to remove? And with that being said, can I have a motion, please?
Sure, I'll make a motion. Motion to accept the consent agenda is written by electronic vote.
I'll second.
Clerk, we have a motion and a second. Please call the vote.
That passes unanimously, Mayor.
Thank you, ma'am. Moving right along, we're on item 10. New business is reappointment to the Municipal Property Corporation Board. Which one will be taking that one? Vice Mayor?
On November 18th, 2019, Gary Brown's term on the Municipal Corporation Board will come due for renewal. He submitted the renewal application letter choosing to be reappointed. Guy Brown was first appointed to a partial term on his board on November 1st, 2018, to fill an existing term. And this reappointment will be his second consecutive term. Myself, Councilmembers Anderson and Grossman are recommending the reappointment of Guy Brown to a term with a renewal date of November 18th, 2022. And I don't think he's here, but if you are, we want you to come forward. So we'll just ask for a motion and a second then.
Sounds good, ma'am.
I'll make a motion. Council members and
Guy Brown.
Yeah, I'm just reading what's here. Okay. I make a motion to reappoint Guy Brown to the Municipal Property Corporation Board by electronic vote.
I'll second.
Clerk, please call the vote.
That passes unanimously, Mayor.
Thank you, ma'am. Moving on, 10B. Prescott Country Club Fire Hydrant Project CIP number W468, construction contract award. Welcome.
Good evening. You kind of caught me by surprise there. I knew the agenda was long tonight, and I thought it was going to last like a long time after we reconvened, but it was a whole lot quicker than I thought. All right. So what you have in front of you is a contract for installing 13 new fire hydrants down in the Prescott Country Club, and we received four bids for the project. The low bid was provided by Yavapai Contracting LLC in the amount of $93,420. And so we are recommending that we award the contract in the full amount for the installation of those fire hydrants. There is a display up on the screen that shows existing fire hydrants, and those are the very small red dots, and there's not a lot of them on there. And the bigger orange dots are the ones that we're adding to basically provide better fire protection services to that area. So if you have any questions.
Real quick, sir, when's the last time we've done this there? Or have we ever done it before?
We have added fire hydrants in the past. It's been quite a long time. And so, you know, and there are other areas of town where we probably need more fire hydrants, but it's not as easy to add them as it is, for example, here in the country club. And the reason for that is, in the country club, all of the water mains are actually out in the roads. Most of the areas of the older parts of Prescott Valley, those water mains run in easements behind the houses. And so the only places where we can add additional fire hydrants are where they come out and cross, get close to streets, because the fire department's not going to go climbing over your fence looking for a fire hydrant. So it's not as easy to add them in other parts of Prescott Valley. And so, it has been a while since we've done this.
Great, thank you. Any other questions or comments, Council? If not?
I'll be glad to make a motion. I'm always glad when we can manage another fire hydrant for all the reasons you said. Motion to approve award of a construction contract to the lowest responsive bidder, Yavapai Contracting LLC, in the amount of $92,420 for the Prescott Country Club Fire Hydrant Project by electronic vote.
I'd like to make a second.
Clerk, please call the vote.
Your screen not coming up, Mayor?
It's not coming up, no, ma'am.
Okay, we'll do this the slow way. Vice Mayor Nye, how do you wish to vote?
That's a big yes.
Councilmember Anderson?
Yes.
Councilmember Grossman?
Yes.
Councilwoman Hunt?
Yes.
Councilman Packard?
Yes.
Councilwoman Schumacher?
Yes.
And Mayor Palguda?
Yes.
Okay, that passes unanimously, Mayor.
Thank you, ma'am. Moving on to item 11, comments from the public. Anyone wish to say something tonight? No? Okay. Give me a quick night, folks. We'll just move on to item 12. We're going to motion to convene into executive session in order to conduct the annual review and evaluation of the performance of the magistrate judge Keith Carson. The executive session is scheduled pursuant to ARS 38-431.03A1, which allows for discussion or consideration of employment, assignment, or appointment of a public officer, appointee, or employee. Can I have a motion, please?
I'll make a motion to recess into executive session.
Can I have a second?
I'll make a second.
Sorry. Clerk, please call the vote. Again, not coming up.
Vice Mayor Nye?
Yes.
Councilmember Anderson?
Yes.
Councilmember Grossman?
Yes.
Councilmember Hunt?
Yes.
Councilmember Beckert?
Yes.
Councilmember Schumacher?
Yes.
And Mayor Palguda?
Yes.
Passes unanimously, Mayor.
Thank you. Ladies and gentlemen, thank you for coming out this evening. It was a real special evening for the town of Prescott Valley, and at this time we have to ask you to leave. You don't have to go home, but you can't stay here.